हेलो एवरीवन। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड कवर्ड द बिटुमिन एज अ पेमेंट मटेरियल। सो कंटिन्यूइंग फ्रॉम दैट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट कटबैक बिटुमिन, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इमल्शन एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टार। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द कटबैक बिटुमिन। नाउ द कटबैक बिटुमिन इज अ बिटुमिन हुज विस्कोसिटी इज रिड्यूस्ड बाय द एडिशन ऑफ volatile dilutant. Okay, when you reduce the viscosity of the conventional bitumen by the addition of some volatile dilutant, then that bitumen is called as cutback bitumen. Okay, so what happens is your bitumen is added with the volatile dilutant, and this combination, that is cutback bitumen, when laid on this road surface, the volatile solvent get evaporated. Okay, so the volatile solvent get evaporated, and in the road surface we have a thin layer of bitumen. Now, as we have discussed previously, that there is a very specific range in which the bitumen has to be heated up and is mixed with the conventional aggregate. Okay, so bitumen, conventional bitumen, has to be first heated, then mixed at a certain temperature range with the aggregates, and then at that temperature range it is laid on the road and the casting of the road is done. But what will happen if we are working on a colder region? Okay, what we'll do when we are working in the colder region, then the desired temperature, achieving that desired temperature, becomes a very tedious task. So in those scenarios, your cutback bitumen proves to be very beneficial. Okay, what you do is you have a combination, right? You have a combination of bitumen and volatile diluted. Just take the material, put it on the road and spread it. As you spread, the volatile solvent get evaporated, and the volatile solvent, as it get evaporated, we have a thin layer of bitumen. The rate of hardness and the viscosity depends upon the characteristic of the bitumen and property of volatile. And based upon the hardening, we have three kind of cutback bitumen. We have rapid curing bitumen, we have medium curing bitumen, and we have slow curing bitumen. So by this we mean the time period required by the volatile solvent to evaporate. In the rapid curing, as soon as we apply the solvent on the road surface, it get evaporated, while in the slow curing it takes a certain amount of time, and the time range when it is in between the rapid curing and slow curing, that is called as your medium curing. Now the identification or the grading of the cutback bitumen is done by the abbreviation of the grade, that is RC represent rapid curing, MC represent medium curing, and SC represent slow curing, and the numerical value in front of these represent the viscosity grading. That is, lower the number, lower will be the viscosity of the cutback bitumen. So if I say we have cutback bitumen RC0, MC0, SC0, so what does this mean is that the viscosity of this is same. Viscosity of these cutback bitumen is same, however their type is different. Okay, we have three different type of cutback bitumen. We have rapid curing bitumen, we have medium curing bitumen, and we have slow curing bitumen. That is the rate at which the volatile material will evaporate and we will get a well prepared road, right? Now there are certain tests that are conducted over the cutback bitumen to study their property. We have viscosity test, we have distillation test, penetration test, and flash point test. Okay, so this is your cutback bitumen. Then next we have emulsion. Now when bitumen is mixed with water, in the presence of some emulsifier, then the combined product that we get is called as emulsion. So your emulsion is a combination of bitumen, the conventional bitumen, plus water. And we have discussed that the conventional bitumen has a affinity to water. That is, the conventional bitumen will never mix with water, right? So in order to ensure a proper mixing of bitumen with water, we add a emulsifier. We add a emulsifier. Okay, this emulsifier enables the mixing of bitumen with water. So the combination of these three, the combination of bitumen, water and emulsifier is called as emulsion. Now this emulsifier that we add is a surface active agent. Okay, and emulsifier keeps the bitumen in its fine droplet state by disallowing it to mix with other droplet, and since the bitumen droplet are very fine, they remain in a suspended stage. So what does this mean is that, you see, bitumen does not dissolve with water. So to ensure the mixing of bitumen with water, emulsifier is added. Now as soon as the bitumen, so let's say we have a jar and we have bitumen, okay, we have bitumen and we have water, and both are non-soluble substance, that bitumen does not dissolve with water. So as soon as emulsifier is added, as soon as a emulsifier, as soon as an emulsifier is added, so this emulsifier, what it does is that it breaks the bitumen into fine droplet. It breaks the bitumen into fine droplet. So what it does is it breaks the bitumen into fine droplets. And surround the bitumen particle with itself. Okay, so each of the bitumen particle is surrounded by emulsifier. Okay, each of the bitumen particle is surrounded by the emulsifier, that is, and overall this whole assembly, whole material is present in water. Okay, and since this bitumen particles are very fine, they remain in suspended stage. The reason for using emulsion is that emulsion helps us to repayment work. Now this emulsion, the use of emulsion is that your emulsion can be used in wet conditions. Your emulsion can be used in wet conditions and can be used for repayment work. Okay, so in wet conditions where the implementation of conventional bitumen is not possible, so in that case we can use emulsion. Plus in the repairment work, in the maintenance work, we use emulsion. And bitumen with penetration grade value of 190 to 320 are emulsified. So now let us in brief discuss the manufacturing process of emulsion. The first stage is that the water is mixed with the emulsifier. Okay, your water is mixed with the emulsifier, and the choice of emulsifier is based upon the ionic nature of the overall mix, the type of bitumen you are using and the overall ionic nature of the mix. Now this combination, this water plus emulsifier combination, in this combination the bitumen is added, and the whole assembly is rotated at a very high speed. Okay, so the water emulsified mix is added with the bitumen in a colloidal mill or in a high speed mixture. So we have a mixture in which the combination of water plus emulsifier is put, and along with that the bitumen is put, and the whole assembly is rotated at a very high speed. So at this high speed, the breakage of a bitumen particle takes place, and the emulsifier form a coating around that, and then the bitumen is present in the water in the suspended stage. Then we have type of emulsion, and this is based upon, as we have discussed on the ionic charge, we have anionic bitumen emulsion, where the tiny droplet of bitumen are negatively charged. We have cationic bitumen emulsion, where the droplet of the bitumen are positively charged, and this is the most favored form of bitumen of emulsion. So your cationic bitumen emulsion is the most favored form of emulsion. So if we have the silica based aggregate, then what we'll do is we'll use cationic based emulsion, because the surface of silica on the aggregate is positively charged. And just like cationic bitumen, we have three variety of emulsion. We have rapid settling emulsion, we have medium settling emulsion, and we have slow settling emulsion. And just like cationic bitumen, it depends upon the rate at which the water evaporates. The most preferred emulsion is the slow settling emulsion, because here the water evaporates at a very slow rate, and the overall bitumen that we get is of like fully dried stage. Now there are certain advantages of using bitumen emulsion. The first is, as we have discussed, it is used for maintenance and repairment work. It can be used in wet weather condition. These are eco-friendly, because you see, when we use conventional bitumen, a certain temperature range has to be reached, right? And there the energy is consumed way too much. Plus there is a generation of volatile material, right? So these are avoided when we are working with the bitumen emulsion. Just like conventional bitumen, these are also used in soil stabilization. It does not require extra heat. There is no wastage in placing and laying of the bitumen. And they possess anti-stripping properties. That is, when conventional bitumen is exposed to water, then stripping of bitumen from the aggregate particle takes place, right? While the bitumen emulsion possess anti-stripping properties, that is, when a prolonged exposure of the bitumen emulsion to water is done, there is no stripping between the aggregate and the bitumen emulsion. And based upon the type of material we are using, the choice of the type of bitumen emulsion is done. The rapid setting type of bitumen emulsion is used for the surface of roads. Medium setting type is used when we are using premix of bitumen emulsion and coarse aggregate. The slow setting is used for fine aggregates. Despite the advantage, there are certain limitation for bitumen emulsion. The limitations are that the storage of the bitumen varies from few days to 6 months. So there is not, we cannot store the bitumen emulsion for a longer period of time. So that is a limitation. So if and when the desire of bitumen emulsion is there, then a limited quantity of material has to be bought, right? Because storing for a longer duration will reduce its efficiency. Setting time may vary due to temperature, winds, and type of emulsion. The second point is setting time may vary due to temperature, wind, and type of emulsion. Okay, based upon the type of emulsion, the temperature conditions, and based upon the type of emulsion, temperature, wind, the setting time may vary. And not a single type of emulsion can be used everywhere. It depends upon the condition to condition. And of course, as we discussed, it depends upon the type of material that we are using. Then the third type of adhesive material we have is tar. So the tar is basically obtained by the destructive distillation. Okay, your tar is obtained by the destructive distillation. That is, the material is burned till the overall material is completely destroyed, right? The overall chemical composition of the material is completely destroyed. Okay, so your tar is a viscous liquid that is obtained by the burning of wood or coal in the absence of air. So your coal tar and wood tar are the most common form of tar that are used, and coal tar is distilled from the petroleum and coal source, while your wood tar is obtained from the burning of the organic materials like vegetation under destructive distillation. So the manufacturing of tar is done through destructive distillation. Okay. The manufacturing of tar is done through destructive distillation. That is the material, and in case the most common material is coal or wood. Okay, so whatever with the material, it is burned in the absence of air, till the overall composition of the material changes, right? So the tar is the viscous liquid obtained when the natural organic material goes under destructive distillation in the absence of air. Two common type of tar that are used are coal tar and wood tar. And coal tar is obtained by the destructive distillation of petroleum and other coal source, while the wood tar is obtained by the destructive distillation of organic material like vegetation. So this destructive distillation can be divided into three stages. First is carbonization of coke to produce crude tar. Then that is the destruction or burning of the source material to obtain the crude tar. And then in the second stage, the refining and distillation of this crude tar is done. And in the third stage, that is where we get the tar, there the crude tar is mixed with some solvent or distillation oil. Okay, so when this crude tar is mixed with some solvent or distillation oil, the final product we get is the tar or the road tar. Talking about the grades, we have RT1, RT2, RT3, 4 and 5. That is, numerical value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 represent the viscosity grading, where road tar 1 has low viscosity, used for surface painting under exceptional cold weather. Okay, so it is the viscosity of RT1 is very less, where RT5 has the highest viscosity. For Indian climatic condition, RT2 is used, and RT3 and RT4 is used for the surface painting, renewal works and the pre-mixing respectively. Okay, so at the end, let us discuss few difference between bitumen and tar, and it is like most commonly asked in exams. Your bitumen is a petroleum derived product, while your tar is obtained by the destructive distillation of coal or wood. Okay, while in production of bitumen, we use fractional distillation. Okay, and the crude petroleum is used for the derivation of bitumen, while for tar, we use coal or wood through destructive distillation. And in fractional distillation, in fractional distillation, the chemical composition of the material remains intact, while destructive distillation, as we know, the chemical composition of the material changes. Your bitumen is less temperature susceptible, while your tar is more temperature susceptible. Your bitumen has less free carbon content, here the carbon content is more. Your bitumen is soluble in carbon disulfide and carbon tetrachloride, while your tar is soluble in toluene. So these are asked in the objective, that your tar is soluble in toluene, carbon disulfide, carbon tetrachloride, or none of them or all of them. So your tar is soluble in toluene, while your bitumen is soluble in carbon disulfide and carbon tetrachloride. Okay, so this was all about the adhesive material used for the construction of bituminous road. And conventionally, bitumen is used for the construction. Bitumen or modified bitumen are used for the adhesive agent for the construction of bituminous road. And for maintenance purposes and in special conditions, the cutback bitumen and emulsions are used. The use of tar is confined to just repairment work. Okay, apart from that, the bitumen is used for the construction of bituminous road, also called as flexible road. We will discuss why they are called as flexible road in the upcoming lectures. Apart from that, we also have cement as an adhesive material, and cement is used for the construction of concrete road, and the concrete road are called as rigid pavement. and we have discussed in detail about the properties of the concrete when we were discussing about the concrete mix design. Okay, so there is no need to discuss it again, right? So this was all about the pavement material. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Okay, thank you.